We are getting started into this one quick. First game of the playoffs of the Fear 500. Drees finishing seeded fourth. Robo finished seeding five. Winner of this game goes on to play Kinsei and grabs themselves $60. Drees, the higher seed in the matchup, had the option, or not so much option, we sort of assumed that he would be taking a west-east trade-off, as he is the only West player in the league, and he came into this game with the higher seed. Lots of chatter about this, that, the other, US East and how other tournaments run, but this is how we've been running this one. Anyways, the last moment, Drees agrees to give Robo server advantage starting on East, which he did not have to do, but he did it last moment. So we're going to go back and forth and back and forth starting on US East. Robo's going to get his first goal of the game. Normally these regular season games only worth $5, but now these guys playing not only for a chance to make even more, but $60 at least in this matchup. Drees going to get his first goal of the game. He's playing this one in the Fennec. He's been dabbling with the Batmobile late in series, but so far always going right back to an Octane hitbox, all reliable. Robo, one of the few Dominus players we've seen playing in ones, as it seemingly has become much more popular to play as of late. Nice placement here by Drees, getting first possession off kickoff. You don't have to grab boost. Chip this one up to himself. And not waiting for the second bounce and rushing that one a little bit faster than maybe Robo expected is the reason why he sneaks it in. So often players wait to gain that extra power on the half volley, but instead Drees taking the volley, puts it in the top of the net and is able to squeeze one past Robo with just pure speed. There's not much to the placement of this shot here, as Robo heading to his corner to grab boost and realizes too late that Drees has an opportunity to shoot, so Drees will go up 3-1. Yeah, Christian, there was much debate today on whether or not we should be playing only East or giving Drees back and forth East-West. Ever since the beginning of this league, we've been giving Drees the opportunity to switch back and forth, so we're going to stick with that for now. Nice double jump pop into a potential bump. To get Robo out of net. Robo is such a great defender, as we always say. But one way to handle those great defenders is to try and take them out of the net. Drees taking control once again. Off kickoff. Even when he's not scoring these right away, he does give himself the first opportunity, but the counterattack is going to go in for Robo. Is Drees maybe just not realizing how dangerous of a situation he was in? Nice wave dash from Robo to get himself to the ball and able to smack a power shot on with absolutely no boost. Drees thinking he was in control of the situation, as he definitely had the boost control, but Robo finds a way to get it in with low boost. He's going to slam it on the back wall off kickoff. Drees playing it slow, starting a dribble. Fake challenge from Robo causes Drees to go up early, and he's continuing to stay on top of it, trying to prevent Robo from being able to take it away, but will eventually just hand the ball over to a very patient Robo. Shot from the corner is not in. Counterattack opportunities wide open, and Drees is going to be able to secure it. Not hard for a player like him, as Robo needs to put a much more dangerous shot on net if he doesn't want to see it counterattacked right back into his own. Drees was disappointed. Robo was disappointed to see that Drees did not get the win against Sharp. If he had gotten that win, it would have made himself the third seed, and he wouldn't be in a game against Robo. But he did end up dropping the last three last night against Sharp, getting reverse swept, so now he finds himself playing from the four seed, and if he's able to win, he'll be playing Kinsei instead of Chronic. But that's a real pick-your-poison type situation here. Drees up early 5-2. I think these guys are ready for any challenge that is put in front of them. Drees doing well to stay on top of the ball and stay active on the defensive end. almost able to turn it around for a goal, but he's going to take this one around the world, grabbing all the boosts. Robo is already supersonic, though, with 82, so he did not need to use any boost to keep up. Dries puts this one off his back corner, eventually convinces Robo to leave as he needs to go reset and grab boost. Dries' first bounce is high, and he comes back down to the ground, a little bit worried that Robo is going to try and go, but in the shadowing position, he's not able to get there. Dries takes this one off the wall, soft tap towards the net, is not going to find anywhere close to going to the back. Robo's flick is super high. Interesting decision from Dries to come up early instead of trying to just play away the rebound off the back walls. That one was certainly not in, but Dries is keeping Robo out for now. High tap, and Dries likes to play it very patiently, three quarters of the way into the net, but he catches it and flicks it out. And his patience will pay off as possession resets here, but Robo's got it once again, trying. Nice flick from him, another dominant flick too high. Dries is able to get back to the net. Faking, challenging early, and Robo makes the perfect read as he takes his flip at the perfect time. Does not fall for the Dries initial challenge, and then Dries with the super early pre-jump, maybe afraid of something that Robo could do with the ball, putting it on top of his car and hitting a flick or something like that. But anyways, the pre-jump ends up being an easy read for Robo as he sees all he needs to do is keep it low and put it wide, and Dries is not going to be able to get back on the ground to get in front of it. But Dries will keep the lead for now. Up to this flick, not strong enough to be threatening. Dries playing so patiently on his back wall, but maybe a little bit too patiently as he runs out of boost to take this one away. Trying to get soft touches in every opportunity he can. Another soft touch as he tries to get behind it, but loses possession, and it's going to be an easy tap in for Robo. 40 seconds left. Dries' lead slowly dwindling away. Hasn't scored in what feels like the past few minutes. Nice 50-50 from him. Is going to push the ball back towards Robo's side. But Dries has not had possession in a while, as Robo has been in control of whatever's been going on. Has Robo found the corner? He has. There was not a big window to score this shot. Robo taking a speedy ground shot, but they're just... That was the only place it could be possibly be put, and actually it might have even been coming out on its own if Dries hadn't tried to save it. It might have been pushing back out to midfield, but you can't blame Dries for trying to get behind that ball. 17 seconds left, and the momentum is definitely in Robo's favor. He's going to hit a flip reset and clutches it at the last second. 13 seconds left. Uses the flip reset, which keeps Dries glued to the ground, but ends up using it to wave dash and pop back up into the ball, and it's going to push it over Dries. Robo going up 6-5. Stealth in chat trying to redeem a 1v1 against me. Stealth, you gotta play sharp first. Dries, 5 seconds left. Flick on the back wall. Does not go in. He's able to keep it up on the backboard, but he has to flick it hard just to stay under it. And the backflip after pressure from Robo will mean a first GG in favor of Robo on his East server. Ooh, love it. We're gonna go hop over to US West now. Game number two. Dree is saying it's over in chat. We speculated whether or not we were gonna see the Batmobile again, but no, we switch from the Fennec over to the Octane. But now we're on US West. Let's check the pings real quick. 76 versus 44. It's interesting that Robo was so hesitant to play on West servers. I think maybe East players are just so used to never going over 50 ping. He's going to go for an air dribble here. Nice second touch from him, but Robo's able to keep it out. Robo has a knack of keeping very good shots out. Will he be able to get a counterattack goal? Looks like he went for a little bit of a pogo, but ended up dropping it down in front of him and pushing it over to the corner. And that will work out as Dries is not able to find the angle to take it away. But Robo looking like he was trying to set up maybe a 180 degree flick. Realized he didn't have it, but recovers back in time and pushes it off to the side. And Robo's going to go up early in game number two as well. Dries, slow dribble in front of the net. Not going to be threatening enough for a defender like Robo. Air dribble back down to the ground. Pops it up to the top of the net. It does not find its way in. Another dribble from Dries. He's going to have to go much more dangerous than the first time around. This time he is going to threaten the bump. And that'll be enough for this ball to float ever so slowly in. Dries' fake touch at midfield convinces Robo to go back to the net, so he's going to have boost and possession, and he will be able to get past the elite defender as Dries just gets a well-timed touch right outside the box. Perfect timing after the commit early by Robo. Or not so much early, late really, but just a great timing play. We'll push it above him. 2-1. In favor of Dries. Are we going to start seeing why it's over here soon? We'll have to find out. This game a little bit lower scoring as these two feel each other out. Dries likely not expecting to be in this position down one against Robo. Nice challenge from Dries. It's going to be an easy bucket. So he's going to take it up for a potential double tap just in case it came off the top wall. But it'll go in immediately as Robo just trying to sneak it past Dries towards the net. And that is a risky play. Delayed kickoff from Robo. He's had enough of Dries taking possession. He's going to start his dribble. Early challenge from Dries. Will probably not be able to. I should not call that too soon. I did not think Dries was going to be able to get around this ball and corral it back in the net, but that's the reason why these guys are the best. Perfectly placed power slide. It's going to chip it up, set himself up to put in a fourth goal. Robo, kickoff win for him. He's going to try and doink it into the net. Doesn't quite make it, but puts on a tough shot that forces a difficult save for Dries. He's have to follow it up playing backwards, but he does succeed. He's able to grab a couple pads as he sets up a shadow defense against Robo. Robo going for another one of his plays where he tries to pogo it, it almost seems like, but then brings it back down. Always looks like Robo is going to let this one land and pogo it, but instead he just sets himself up for a power shot that ends up bouncing back off Dries and tapping in. Dries low dribble. The air dribble bump has been working for him, so I'm not surprised to see him go back to it. This time he doesn't get enough power on it, and he absolutely should have been counterattacked here, and he still might be as Dries ends up scoring it on himself. Robo's touch absolutely was not going in this situation. Robo had an opportunity to put a long shot in, and then he tried to rush it and was not going to see it go in, or maybe he was, as Dries slams it off the back wall and then back into himself and in. So he tried his best to keep it out, but he won't. He what a saves himself as he still has a one goal lead with 2 minutes, 22 seconds left to go. 90 degree flick from him at midfield is just a little bit too far away from the net to really catch Robo off guard. But Dries is king of the continued attack as he will keep putting the pressure on. Robo's takes him out of the picture, which means he'll be able to set up a dribble here. Dries actually had an opportunity to dive on him early as Robo had an awkward turnaround in his own corner, but he ends up faking it. Robo's going to try the long shot immediately, and Dries saves it away, not able to grab his own boost. He tries to grab the ball and start a dribble, but it's not going to work, and Robo will tie it back up. Insane luck, says Dries in the chat. Reset for Robo, but early challenge from Dries. Able to take it away. Robo passing it off the corner. Dries can take a low dribble, and Robo gets the perfect read on him. Dries once again trying to set up a dribble, and Robo takes it away off the top of his car. Dries just not corralling that ball like he expected to, and Robo is looking at an opportunity to put himself on triple match point against Dries. When Dries and Robo played, it was a long time ago, I think right as the league was starting, and Dries, I believe, got a 3-0 on Robo. Dries yet to win a game since that second game he won against Sharp. This should be a good opportunity to score. Robo, Dries playing it, I mean, extra slow. Robo was able to tap it away for a moment. What a goal line save, and Dries playing ever so carefully to make sure he can put it out of Robo's reach, but he's going to tie it up 5-5. But as I was saying, Dries on a little bit of a streak of losses since winning game number 2 against Sharp, but nice flick that's going to make it past Robo. Seems like there's a couple ways to make it past this defender, and that is a quick playoff kickoff where Robo's not able to position maybe as perfectly as he would want, and bumping him, but otherwise he's keeping it out. Dries about to break the seal. He's trying to play this one off the wall, and he does find a way to get it in. It seems like maybe Robo helped it in. Let's watch this again from Robo's perspective. Oh, just a missed flip. Might be the difference between him being able to get back and not. And yeah, he does tap this one maybe a little bit towards the net. I'm not sure Dries got the angle he needed. But all of a sudden, after two quick goals, after tying it up, Dries is up 7-5, 41 seconds left, and Robo has to put the pressure on, and Robo's going to tap it in his own net. Robo actually electing to play fairly far away from Dries, considering the goals he needed to make up, and Dries was still able to take advantage of it. Dries just a little bit in no man's land as he's not able to find a way to defend and attack at the same time. Dries can let this one come to the ground. Demo on Robo. Robo's up earlier than him, but taps it off the backboard, and this will be the end of the game. Game number 2. Robo's going to get a 6th one, but 4 seconds left, and Dries gives the early GG. He does not have faith in Robo to get 2 more. That'll be it. Dries is going to tie it back up 1-1. He is going to let Robo have the last goal to make it look a little bit closer than it was. But both these guys winning on their home servers. We'll see if it ends up going that way the distance. And Dries might regret handing over that server advantage to Robo. Game 3, Robo versus Dries. Robo so far has already done more than he did when these two played in the regular season. Dries was able to take him down 3-0, but Robo takes the first game, and Dries the second in this much more crucial quarterfinal in the playoffs. Dries catching this ball, deciding to take Robo out, but forgot to make sure the ball was online. He still got the demo and will eventually squeeze it in. He goes for the much more disrespectful fake than hitting it in early. I think he had an opportunity to push this one in early and decided to make Robo jump and instead tap it in behind him. Kickoff win for Dries. He should be able to tap this one in. Oh my, that is absolutely a monstrous whiff for Dries, who should have no problem putting that one in. And actually, I'm surprised that Robo wasn't able to hit the counterattack either. It was certainly much tougher for him as Dries had was barreling down on top of him. But both these guys missing what is normally easy shots for them. Dries almost air dribbles it into his own net. It does cost him every last bit of boost he has in order to take it away. So now he's in a low boost situation at midfield, which is always tough to keep that offensive player out of your net. But he doesn't really do it, but Robo does it himself as he slams it off the back wall. Robo had an opportunity to put a goal on, as he did play that correctly, but then just had a poor finish. And that is going to be a 2-point swing instead of Robo tying it up. It will be another goal to Dries. Dries Long air dribble, saving his boost for the last moment, trying to get a little bit extra height as he just crossed over the line of the box outside the net, but was not able to get enough to get it over Robo. These two look like they're both looking for the demo on each other, but Dries is the one to connect on it, and it will give him a third goal as he's been able to keep a clean sheet so far in game number three. Maybe he's all warmed up and ready to go. Dries moving back to his net, power sliding into the boost. Gonna take control of this ball, trying to convince Robo to pass it away as Robo is panic flipping under it. He will fully retreat here, and Dries uses the last bit of boost to take a long shot. Good timing from him, but he's not able to prevent what was a nice save from Robo despite taking his boost. Dries being extra patient in his net this series, and although it's cost him a couple goals, I think overall it has been working better for him. Nice dominus flick from Robo, and he will be able to continue it up. These dominus flicks seem to get just a little bit extra power, a nice 90 degree. Dries is able to take it offline for a moment, but he goes flying into net and doesn't have a chance against the follow-up. Dries' opportunity to set up an air dribble here. He's going to go for a potential flip reset. Looks like he bailed on it last second and ends up just putting in an air dribble against Robo's back wall and gets prepared for the counterattack that he know is gonna be coming soon. These two pinch it in the corner. Gonna give time for both of them to grab boost and reset here. Robo taking away an air dribble, and Dries can't decide whether or not he wants to challenge early on the wall or come back down to the ground. He does decide to come back down to the ground, but head right back up into the air, and it was a little bit too little, too late as he connects into Robo's car and the ball goes flopping in. Dries doing his signature move, keeping the continual pressure on. Doesn't need to put a nasty shot on the first time. In fact, puts in quite a weak shot as he misses his flick. But so comfortable going for the second and third opportunities. Dries, kickoff goal, puts himself up three. First time he's up three since going up 3-0. He's able to take back the two goals that Robo put on top of him. Dries pressuring on the back wall of Robo, forcing him to tap it away. Dries trying to take this ball into the corner and maintain possession while grabbing boost. He's not able to do so, but he convinces Robo to pass it over to him. Both these guys playing chicken, trying to see who's going to pull the trigger first. Dries drops it in a slow roll towards Robo, and Robo's, at least for now, able to keep it out of the net. Dries continuing the pressure here, and he's going to get a couple bumps and then try and backflip this one in maybe, or take it in normally. He tries to get a disrespectful third fake. That was absolutely filthy by Dries. He had an open opportunity, and he could have tapped in a sixth goal, but he tried to push the limits and go for one more fake. And that's not going to work for him. Robo definitely trying to slam into Dries there on his retreat. Was hoping Dries was going to go up for the clear early, and then Robo would have connected with him hard and been able to tap in an easy goal. But Dries' patience yet again pays off. Minute left. Three goals left for Robo to send this one to overtime. Dries so patient in front of his net right now, not using a single bit of boost. He does not worry about pushing this past Robo. He knows he's in this defensive effort for the long haul and is going to need his 70 boost for later. He's going to set a soft roll to himself. Robo needs to put some kind of pressure on. Dries' flick is weak, and Robo will be able to tap it away. Dries trying to take Robo for a ride. Ends up not working exactly how he would have liked as Robo's hitbox hits the boost early. A little flip reset in defense from Dries. Not sure if he actually connected on that flip reset and was able to use it or not, but the ensuing play coming from that will give him a sixth goal and certainly secure game number three for him as he puts himself on match point against Robo. Come on, Robo. Hit a Johnski flick. What's a Johnski flick? Dries flip reset. Takes it to the ground. Using the flip reset late. Not able to get it past Robo, but it's not going to matter. Robo's going to put on at least another third. Dries needs 2 minutes. He's got to get something. Very interesting. What is it Dries is going to get? Speculation in the chat. Please, GG, as we're going to switch back over to West for game number 4. How do I not know what a Johnski flick is? What are you talking about? What's a Johnski flick? Oh, wait, it's like starting to do a breezy, but then flicking it afterwards? Like, not actually doing a musty? It's like a breezy without the musty, kind of? Hey, nice transition. Thank you, Blundered. It's like tornado. Oh, these guys are ready to go. It's a tornado flick, but no like musty at the end. I feel like the breezy is a tornado flick with the musty. But here we are, game number 4. Back on West servers. Dries just needs to win either this West game or the game number 5 back on East. Dries staying on top of this ball, despite being in a low boost situation. Chat, begging for the Johnski flick. Will we see it? Robo has an opportunity to put something on easy, but no. He needed to corral that ball back into the net, as it was not headed in. This flick pops it over Dries early. Robo takes the early lead in game number 4. He desperately wants to see chat using the game 5 hype emote. Nice air dribble from Dries. He noticed at the last moment he needed to switch it up and tried to slow it down as much as he could using his wheels to try and sneak it under Robo, but it didn't end up working out. But not a bad attempt from him. Robo's going to put it off the back wall, so long shot from Dries. Forces out a nice save from Robo as he gets enough separation between his own goal and the ball in order to prevent the instant counterattack, but then he leaves an open window as he thought he bought himself so much time that he could grab boost and come back, but turns out he did not, as he ends up driving towards Dries and getting caught out. He had kept a line towards his front of his net and not out towards Dries. He maybe still would have been able to save that one. Dries trying to go for another epic flick that got him a goal earlier, where he just completely misses and just fouls it up the second time, but this time it's not going to work as well as the first. Soft setup for Robo, nice flip from him to get under the ball just when Dries thought Robo had nothing left. A little bit of a pre-flip to tap it up and over him, nice play from Robo. Dries, perfect opportunity for him to take it high on the bounce dribble. Has yet to really mix up the air dribble much, but he is finally going to find a goal from one of these, as he is threatening, trying to bring something interesting into the mix, but so far has just kind of dribbled it in, and this time the 50-50 right in front of the net is going to pay off for him. Dries tying it up 2-2. Looking to end the series now. Guarantee himself at least $60 prize pool from the playoffs. Just a midfield flick from Dries. Run of the mill as Robo just challenges a little bit late. Setting himself up in a tough spot, being on that side wall. He wanted to pressure the wall dribble, but decided against it. And then power slid and set himself up so far out of position on that side wall, he did not have time to recover and challenge Dries in time, but he's going to put a nice flick of his own after grabbing possession off kickoff. Dries just waiting in net. Not enough boost to make the play he wanted to while pointing directly at Robo. So we tried to challenge early, and he's going to get punished by the Dominus flicking Robo every time. This time, shot from Robo, saved away. Dries has held on to his boost. He's going to try and play this low 50-50 almost definitely. First one's not able to go in, but second tap is high. He forces a tough save from Robo. Robo's taking a nice adventure out to midfield to go grab some boost to make a save. He ended up not really using the boost for much other than to come back to the net, but he does keep it out, so hard to blame him for his strategy. Nice early challenge from Dries, as Robo's been deadly with those dribbles and flicks. One of the best ways to stop them out is to just take the ball away from them so early before they're ready for a challenge. Dries, nice 50 on the wall, and just a little bit of a tap on Robo means it'll be smooth sailing all the way into the net. Got a little tap from Dries. Maybe he didn't notice that he got a little love from Dries on the wall there. Dries challenge at midfield, not able to finish it off as Rusty Robo, someone's talking about Musty in chat, Robo recovers and is able to take away the second shot. Another air dribble bump opportunity for Dries, but then he plays it slow, and then it turns out to be the right decision as another 50-50 is eventually going to go in Dries' favor. But I like the way that Dries is mixing up these air dribble bumps, expecting Robo to potentially go up early to try and avoid the bump. So instead, he pulls back and goes for the 50-50 with him afterwards, and this time it pays off. Robo's flick early is over Dries, and Dries is able to connect with Robo, but that shouldn't have been enough to keep him out. I thought Robo was on his way to a free goal. I wonder if he had a missed touch on the sidewall, if I just thought it was a little bit easier than it truly was. Dries, low boost situation, Robo's going to go grab mid and use all of it to keep the pressure on, but 100 boost spawns under Dries, and he uses a musty just to separate this ball from his own half. It is going to cost him a lot of boost. Robo feels backflipping in front of the ball. Eventually takes it away. This ground shot, not anywhere close to going in, so Dries sets himself up off the sidewall. As he pushes this air drop all the way on that, trying to go for the flip reset, doesn't get it, but actually ends up getting what was almost a nice little ground pinch using Robo to put it in, just ever so slightly too high. And 30 seconds left, and Dries looking like he's going to be able to secure this series if he can keep Robo out for the next 20 seconds. Robo, nice dribble. He's been deadly in these situations, but with no boost, he does not see himself an opportunity to flick. Dries starting another dribble. Gets the flip reset, uses it early, but Robo makes the read. Robo does not let good shots in his net. You almost feel better off putting in a weak one. But that'll be it, as whether or not Robo taps this in or not, it'll be over as Dries takes it 3-1, winning two different games on East and one on his own server. Oh wait, no. Two on his own server and one on East. GG's, man. Thank you, Robo. Ever so much. For playing in the league. Oh wait, it's like starting to do a breezy, but then flicking it afterward, like not actually doing a musty. It's like a breezy without the musty, kinda. Hey, nice transition. Thank you, Blender. It's like tornado. Oh, these guys are ready to go. It's a tornado flick, but no, like musty at the end. I feel like the breezy is a tornado flick with the musty. But here we are, game number four, back on West servers. Breeze just needs to win either this West game or the game number five back on East. Breeze staying on top of this ball despite being in a low boost situation. Chat begging for the Jonsky flick. Will we see it? Robo has an opportunity to put something on easy, but no. He needed to corral that ball back into the net as it was not headed in. This flick pops it over Dries early. Robo takes the early lead in game number four. He desperately wants to see chat using the game five height emote. Nice air dribble from Dries. He noticed the last moment he needed to switch it up and tried to slow it down as much as he could using his wheels to try and sneak it under Robo, but it didn't end up working out. But not a bad attempt from him. Robo's going to put it off the back wall, so long shot from Dries. Forces out a nice save from Robo as he gets enough separation between his own goal and the ball in order to prevent the instant counterattack, but then he leaves an open window as he thought he bought himself so much time that he could grab boost and come back, but turns out he did not, as he ends up driving towards Dries and getting caught out. He had kept a line towards his front of his net and not out towards Dries. He maybe still would have been able to save that one. Dries trying to go for another epic flick that got him a goal earlier, where he just completely misses and just fouls it up the second time, but this time it's not going to work as well as the first. Soft setup for Robo, nice flip from him to get under the ball just when Dries thought Robo had nothing left. A little bit of a pre-flip to tap it up and over him. Nice play from Robo. Dries, perfect opportunity for him to take it high on the bounce dribble. Has yet to really mix up the air dribble much, but he is finally going to find a goal from one of these, as he is threatening, trying to bring something interesting into the mix, but so far has just kind of dribbled it in, and this time the 50-50 right in front of the net is going to pay off for him. Dries tying it up 2-2, looking to end the series now, guarantee himself at least $60. Prize pool from the playoffs. Just a midfield flick from Dries, run of the mill, as Robo just challenges a little bit late, setting himself up in a tough spot being on that side wall. He wanted to pressure the wall dribble but decided against it, and then power slid and set himself up so far out of position on that side wall he did not have time to recover and challenge Dries in time, but he's going to put a nice flick of his own after grabbing possession off kickoff. Dries just waiting in net. Not enough boost to make the play he wanted to while pointing directly at Robo. So we try to challenge early, and he's going to get punished by the dominant flicking Robo every time. This time, shot from Robo, saved away. Dries has held on to his boost. He's going to try and play this low 50-50 almost definitely. First one's not able to go in, but second tap is high and forces a tough save from Robo. Robo's taking a nice adventure out to midfield to go grab some boost to make a save. He ended up not really using the boost for much other than to come back to the net, but he does keep it out, so hard to blame him for his strategy. Nice early challenge from Dries, as Robo's been deadly with those dribbles and flicks. One of the best ways to stop them out is to just take the ball away from them so early before they're ready for a challenge. Dries, nice 50 on the wall. And just a little bit of a tap on Robo means it'll be smooth sailing all the way into the net. Got a little tap from Dries. Maybe he didn't notice that he got a little love from Dries on the wall there. Dries challenge at midfield, not able to finish it off as Rusty Robo, someone's talking about Musty in chat, Robo recovers and is able to take away the second shot. Another air dribble bump opportunity for Dries, but then he plays it slow, and then it turns out to be the right decision as another 50-50 is eventually going to go in Dries' favor. But I like the way that Dries is mixing up these air dribble bumps, expecting Robo to potentially go up early to try and avoid the bump. So instead, he pulls back and goes for the 50-50 with him afterwards, and this time it pays off. Robo's flick early is over Dries, and Dries is able to connect with Robo, but that shouldn't have been enough to keep him out. I thought Robo was on his way to a free goal. I wonder if he had a missed touch on the sidewall, if I just thought it was a little bit easier than it truly was. Dries, low boost situation, Robo's going to go grab mid and use all of it to keep the pressure on, but 100 boost spawns under Dries, and he uses a musty just to separate this ball from his own half. It is going to cost him a lot of boost. Robo feels backflipping in front of the ball, eventually takes it away. This ground shot not anywhere close to going in, so Dries sets himself up off the sidewall as he pushes this air dribble all the way on that, trying to go for the flip reset, doesn't get it, but actually ends up getting what was almost a nice little ground pinch using Robo to put it in, just ever so slightly too high. And 30 seconds left, and Dries looking like he's going to be able to secure this series if he can keep Robo out for the next 20 seconds. Robo, nice dribble. He's been deadly in these situations, but with no boost, he does not see himself an opportunity to flick. Dries starting another dribble. Gets the flip reset, uses it early, but Robo makes the read. Robo does not let good shots in his net. You almost feel better off putting in a weak one. But that'll be it, as whether or not Robo taps this in or not, it'll be over as Dries takes it 3-1, winning two different games on East and one on his own server. Oh wait, no. Two on his own server and one on East. GG's, man.